Hey guys, it's Vampire Mike from Sega CD Universe, and I wanted to do a video highlighting movies that sort of remind me a little bit in some facet of Twin Peaks. If you don't know what Twin Peaks is, it's a really good 90s TV show that a few years ago they had made a third season after I think it was 25 years. I recommend you watch it. The first two seasons are some of my favorite. The third season, I'm not a huge fan of, admittedly, but that's a whole other story. So, this is my Twin Peaks Blu-ray set. It's about this high school, like, sweetheart type of girl, hometown, small town girl who gets murdered, and they're trying to figure out who killed her. And it just gets weirder and weirder and weirder. And the first two seasons are on here, along with the Fire Walk With Me movie. So I'm not going to include Fire Walk With Me because obviously that's part of the series. And then the third season came out as a limited event on, was it Showtime or HBO? Showtime. A few years ago, like I said, I didn't love this series, but there were things about it I did enjoy. So if you like Twin Peaks, shout out to Bill Radovich, then I would recommend watching these films. Again, nothing is really like Twin Peaks completely, but there are little things that just remind me of it. So, the first thing is obviously Blue Velvet, which is also by David Lynch. It's a story about Kyle MacLachlan, again from Twin Peaks, who lives in this, I guess, suburban town, and he finds a rotting ear, and there is this whole crazy underworld murder mystery thing going on. Lots to take in, it's a lot to explain. Some great quotable lines, lots of weirdness, strange characters, and very quotable dialogue. Dennis Hopper has some amazing lines. Isabella Rossellini's in it, she's very strange. Laura Dern is in it, so you may recognize her from things like, Wild at Heart and Jurassic Park. But if you like David Lynch and you like Twin Peaks, Blue Velvet should be up there for you to check out. Another one with Kyle MacLachlan that I wholeheartedly recommend, excuse me, is The Hidden. This almost feels like it could be like a side story. In it, Kyle MacLachlan's character is a detective or FBI agent, I forget what it is, tracking down this murderous alien. And I don't want to say too much and spoil too much, but he has this partner that looks a lot like Harry Truman from Twin Peaks. And he's got this weirdness to him, I don't want to say again too much, and they have this like buddy cop thing, but they also don't like each other initially, and they're tracking down this alien, and it just definitely feels like it could be an offshoot of something like Twin Peaks. So if you like the detective stuff from Twin Peaks, and you're a Kyle MacLachlan fan, Blue Velvet as well, check out The Hidden. One that I wouldn't say is extremely like Twin Peaks at all, but has a little bit of that darkness to it, because there's a lot of dark, weird stuff in Twin Peaks. Fear X with John Turturro, I almost said Nicholas Turturro. This was a movie that I got at a thrift store for a buck. And I didn't know what to expect. I just rolled the dice and I really enjoyed it. I should revisit it soon. It's about John Turturro's character, whose wife gets murdered randomly, leaving a mall. And he's a security guard now, I don't remember if he is in the past, in the mall. And he's going over and combing through the tapes, trying to figure out who killed his wife because it's a cold case. And he starts seeing things and hearing things. And there's this very dark, sinister thing going on around him. It's never fully fleshed out. I don't believe there's actually like a, I think the ending is more of a cliffhanger, but it's definitely got that weird darkness of Twin Peaks sort of going on a little bit. So I would recommend Fear X if you haven't seen it. I just finished watching this with my wife. It's a little bit of a long film, but again, Twin Peaksy. Tough Guys Don't Dance. This was a Norman Mailer book. Supposedly, he's a very famous author who also did some films. This is put out by Vinegar Syndrome. This is the Blu-ray. This is about... Oh, and Angelo Badalamenti, who did the soundtrack to Twin Peaks, did the soundtrack to this. This is about this guy played by Ryan O'Neill, who lives in this, like, Cape Cod, small town type of thing. And he's in love with his ex-girlfriend still, and he's married to a sort of redneck con artist, I guess is the best way to put it. And everyone in the town is weird. And not like really Twin Peaks weird, but they're definitely off. Everyone is backstabbing one another, sleeping with one another. There's orgies happening, there's swinging happening, there's murders, there's drug sales. Every character chews the scenery and has these weird-ass lines. The main line that everyone focuses on, and at one point, Ryan O'Neill goes on the beach and reads this letter from Isabella Rossellini, who, you know, from Blue Velvet, and he goes, "Oh God, oh no, oh God, oh no," and it's just, he keeps repeating himself, and the camera starts spinning around, and it's just so weird and, like, cheesy. There's, like, goofy parts of the film that are comedic, but I don't think they're meant to be. Wings Hauser's in it. You know, anything with Wings Hauser has a bit of a cheese and a goofiness to it. He has some really fucked up lines that are funny. He talks about pot at one point, and he's like, "It'll make my ass grow feathers." It's like, what does that even mean? The Ryan O'Neill's dad in it is played by the guy who's the like mob boss or hitman or whatever from Reservoir Dogs, who sets up the the crime spree. The little old man with the bald head with the gruff voice who looks like the Thing from Fantastic Four. And at one point, someone says something to Isabella Rossellini. I don't want to give away too much. And he goes, "You never tell an Italian that they're small potatoes." I've never heard that in my life. Like, they just had these really weird lines. It's a little bit of a long film, almost 2 hours. But if you like that weird, the characters are all strange and they're all after one another and you don't know who's, you know, screwing over who, I would recommend Tough Guys Don't Dance. It's definitely weird. This one is probably, to me, sort of the most Twin Peaks-y. All-American Murder. I have a review coming out in, I think, December on this channel for this movie, so I don't want to say too much, but it involves this guy on the cover here who has this horrible voice throughout the film, and he is dating this blonde girl, and she gets murdered. So, again, sort of Twin Peaks-ish. And he's trying to figure out who murdered her, what happened, things are getting pinned on him. There's all these weird characters. Christopher Walken is the cop that is following the case, but also sort of working in conjunction with the boyfriend. And there's some twists and turns, some dark characters. As I said, the main character has a horrible voice, very squeaky and annoying. And they seem to have a lot of retorts in the movie. So while you're watching, it's like no one can get a line in without the other character having this goofy retort, like making fun of the other character or like a wise-ass crack. And after a while, it's like people don't talk like that. Not everyone has this wit to them that has this strange response. But overall, it's a cheesy, good, you know, thriller, detective mystery thing with some Twin Peaks vibes to it. So I would definitely recommend All-American Murder if you haven't seen it. And then as a bonus, not very Twin Peaks-y, but I almost mentioned Mother Night with Nick Nolte because Cheryl Lee is in it, who plays Laura Palmer. But it's nothing to do with Twin Peaks. But it's a good movie. Check that out if you haven't seen Mother Night. But bonus, Dante's View. Not very Twin Peaks-y. There is like this small, I want to say it's in Las Vegas or Nevada, excuse me, town. And Cheryl Lee comes into the town and she's like a con artist or a bank robber or something of that sort. And she hooks up with these people in this small town. One of them reminds me a lot of Lara Flynn Boyle from Twin Peaks on the cover. And she's just sort of a bastard. And she has that Laura Palmer-esque, like, cute, pretty girl, but you could tell deep down something dark is sort of inside of her. That's sort of where the similarity ends. So that's why it's just kind of a bonus recommendation. It doesn't really have as much as the other films. But these are the films I would recommend if you enjoy the TV series Twin Peaks, like I did. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know if you've seen any of these, what you think, and if you do go out and buy or rent or stream any of them, please come back and tell me if they reminded you of Twin Peaks or not. It's Vampire Mike from Sega CD Universe. Be good.